How's everybody doing today?
Good.
Doing good? Awesome. Good to have everybody here, good to see everybody's faces here. Thanks, bud. Yeah. Let's just take a little bit of time and just pray for a little while. I don't know what God wants to do today, but we'll see what happens there, okay? So Father, I thank you, Lord. Thank you for this day. Thank you for what you're doing in our midst right now. Father, I thank you for your faithfulness and your goodness, Lord. Holy Spirit, we yield ourselves to you right now, Lord. We ask that you prepare our hearts to receive everything that you have for us today. And Father, I thank you, Lord, that you are good and awesome God. That we can rest in you and we can trust you in all things, knowing that it doesn't matter what we're going through, where we're at. Lord God, you are the source, you are the answer. You are the provision for everything that we need. Lord, I pray for all of my brothers and sisters here, Lord. Dealing with different things that is going on in their lives right now, different concerns, different needs. I just really feel like God wants us to open up the service today with prayer for people. If anybody needs prayer for out there, I want to encourage you to come up right now. Right now. People, if you need deliverance, if you need healing, whatever you have need of right now, I encourage you to come up and pray for you. Thank you.
To be honest, I generally don't remember.
If anybody else needs prayer, you guys can feel free to come up to you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. others here, Lord God, or families and friends that are dealing with this same thing, Lord God. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are our source, that your provision is available for us, Lord God. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, that right now that you intervene and bring about everything that's needed, Lord. Send perfect laborers where they're needed, Lord. Reach them right where they're at, Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are enough, that you already paid the price over 2,000 years ago, Lord. You knew that we would be dealing with this today, Lord God, so that provision was already made available for us to walk in victory today. Lord, I pray that you comfort them right now, that you minister to them, Lord, that you just encourage them, that you be their peace right now during this time. Thank you, Father. And Lord, we lift up all of the people right now, our the prodigals out there. Reach them right where they're at, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I just wanted to do something today. I just feel like Jesus to minister to people right now. And I just wanted to do this. I normally wouldn't do something like this, but I just feel like the Holy Spirit is leading me to do this right now. We have a brother here, Lance. You know, he has some needs and stuff. God's doing some things in his life. Sometimes we look at circumstances and whatnot. But the word says that if we see a brother in need and we just say, hey, go be warm, be fed. We don't do nothing about it. We're not really doing what we're called to do. So I just want to be the church today. And whatever you guys can do, I want to do this. And I hope it's okay, but I'm going to do it anyway. And whatever offerings come in today, and if anybody else want to give and help Lance today, then I encourage you guys to give and help in whatever way you can. Okay? And whatever comes in today, and any other way that you guys can help him with his needs. It's the goodness, brother, look up at me here. It's the goodness of God.
Amen.
God is going to love to see you, meet you right where you're at. Just remember that he is your source.
It's the only reason I'm alive right now is because of God. And I know that for a fact. Well, 100 times over in my life. And if it wasn't for those moments where God came to me, or maybe members of the church came to me and told me go left instead of go right, or just sometimes it's even been a shooting star or something in the middle of the night when I'm, you know, looking for drugs, because I'm a drug addict. I admit that. I have a lot of other issues in my life, like mental health, any number of issues that is like just completely overwhelming me at the moment. But what keeps me going through my weeks is knowing that I have the church to come to. Like, this is truly, I feel like you guys is my family. And I know
Amen.
There's times where I may not show it through maybe my actions in my day-to-day life, or like, you know, when I'm sitting in an alleyway about to use again or something like that, and I forget about the church. But every time you guys is here for me, and that's why I know that God is real. No matter how much hardship or whatever comes my way, I'm like, I know that God is real, and that's because of this congregation.
Amen.
And that's like how you said, for people giving, like that's more than I could ever ask for, is to be saved, to be brought into the kingdom of heaven, in spite of, you know, maybe the life I've lived, or even when I was younger, I turned my back on the church. I was against the church just because of little things that I disagreed with. But yet he, you know, he pulled me back in. And that's more than anybody could ever ask for, is to be, and to truly know that, like, that even in my worst moments, I mean, just earlier, I'm sitting here thinking, here I am, you know, on my knees again, asking for forgiveness. And it's like, seems like week in and week out, I keep on just foolish mistakes. And it's not even mistakes, because I know better. It's not even a mistake at that point. But I know I'm not doing it because I know that God will forgive me. And that's the main thing, I think, is that it's just, maybe just, I don't know why I keep on doing these things, but I know that God forgives me every time, and it's the amount of love that is there is just, it's amazing.
Yeah.
I can't believe it. It's sometimes I feel like it's more than I could ever deserve, you know? But it's, and things in my life is just crazy. I mean, I'm planning to check into the mental institute actually after service today. Well, either that or jail, one of the two, because that's kind of where I feel I need to be right now. It's really hard, but I know that God will come wherever I need to be. God will try and help me be there, even if, you know, just now when he was praying for me, I was thinking to myself, like, you know, God, I'm tired of all this struggling. Of like, I feel like I have demons that come into my life, like real, full-fledged demons.
Mm-hmm.
And for me to just be a mortal and have to fight these things that, you know, a lot of times they'll take the form of companionship. And when I look at these demons, I see, like, every person I've ever loved or had feelings for in my life, I see a combination of them, and that should be a warning sign to me right there that, like, something is up right here. This being is, like, emulating everything I've ever wanted in my life, but yet leading me down a path of trouble. And I was sitting up there thinking, like, God, if, you know, I would almost rather be just take my life and bring me into the kingdom right now, it would be a lot easier. But I also know that God doesn't trust us with more than we can handle. And I wish he wouldn't trust me so much sometimes, but it's really hard. Like, and I don't usually feel comfortable talking about these types of things, you know, all kinds of strangers around, but for some reason I do today. And
amen.
I think, you know, your prayer has a lot to do with it. And it's something that I need to speak of, because if we're going to have help in our life from other people, we need to share what our problems are. So I think that's a huge step for me, is just opening up.
Amen.
Definitely.
Amen.
Yes.
So thank you.
That's what the church is for, right?
That's right.
I mean, we can play church, come here, give a kumbayas, hallelujah, praise God, go home, and they don't affect change when somebody needs our help. What's the sense of having church and playing church and not making a difference? brother that can be honest like this in service and still feel unconditional love towards him. No matter what you've been, what you've done, the wholeness of the life. Anybody who thinks that they're above when my brother is here, that you're delusional. Outside of Jesus and what he did in our lives, man, we're all just scumbags.
That's right.
The standard's perfect and none of us are there. Right? The standard is perfect, guys. I can look to my left and look at one person and say, I'm pretty good. And I can look at someone else and feel pretty bad. Right? That's why the word says not to compare ourselves among ourselves. We can look at the situation and we can make judgments or whatever it is, but until the church is willing to do what it needs to do and effect change in the lives of people, be willing to stop a service right now because one brother needs something right now. I have my message prepped, ready to go. The Holy Spirit is telling me stop. That's not where you're going today. Hours and hours of preparation. But sorry, we're not delivering today. We're going to deliver someone today.
That's right.
Because Jesus loves us. He cares that much. You know, if we need to be the church. We need to do whatever we can with people all around us. We need to use wisdom. Four pillars that I'll keep talking about for us. Four pillars of our Christianity that we absolutely need in order for us to be effective in the kingdom of God. It's these four things, and I can guarantee you this, that if you're having a hard time or struggling in life, it's one of these four things that is hindering you. First off, is number one, is our identity in Christ. If you don't have revelation of your identity in Christ, everything else will flow from that case. The second thing is you need revelation of God's unconditional love. It's absolutely essential. And I share this, and I don't have a better example, so I keep sharing the same example with like my kids, right? My kids, I love my kids unconditionally, not because they're perfect, not because they do everything right. Sometimes, believe it or not, they actually do things that they know they're not supposed to do. And they give you that look that they know they're not supposed to do it, but they do it anyway, right? But how does that affect my love for my kids? Right? Still love them. Why? Because of their identity. They're my children.
Amen.
And when you give your life to Jesus, we're children of God. You're accepted like that. Oftentimes we're struggling in our walk with God because we put conditions on our relationship with God. It's a works-based doctrine based on what I do right or what I do wrong. And folks, that's great when you're doing things right, but when you're doing things wrong, and all of a sudden I can't receive from God, I can't believe, I cannot come to God, I cannot come boldly to the throne of grace. Jesus loves us and he cares for us and he accepts us not because of what we do right or wrong, but because we accepted him as our Lord and Savior. The same way that we come to Jesus by simply putting our trust in, putting our faith in Jesus for our salvation is the same way that we receive everything else from God. Amen. And then the other two things that we need to work in is we need to operate in wisdom. Because if we're not operating in wisdom, then the devil is constantly going to be in a place of cleanup rather than being advancing in life. We need to be operating in wisdom. Let me give you an example of that. If God blesses me with a job and I go to work and I'm believing God to get a promotion, to get a raise, to do well, to get blessed financially and all of that, but if I'm constantly complaining and I'm doubting my boss and I show up to work late and I do all these things, I'm not operating in wisdom. As much as God wants to bless us, he's not going to override just the natural aspect of this, right? That's why we need to operate in wisdom. Gotta ask God. The word says, if anyone lacks wisdom, let him ask of God who gives to all liberally and without reproach. But let him ask in faith. We need to ask in faith without doubting, for he who doubts like the wave of the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. Let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. Is it that God does not want to bless us? Is it that God doesn't want to bring about change and see us prosperous and healed and made victorious in every area of our life? Nothing to do with God. God already paid the price over 2,000 years ago so that we could receive everything that we need from him. He already paid the price. Like I shared last week, he's seated at the right hand of the Father. The work has already been done.
Amen.
He's just there cheering us on. Come on, guys, you got this. You got this. I provided everything that you need. You got this. Come on. Go get them, guys. He's our cheerleader right there cheering us on. You got this. We need to operate in wisdom. And the last thing, guys, is we need to know authority. Because the last thing that's going to trip you up is the devil, because he's going to come against us. We need to know our authority as a child of God. See, but if I don't know my identity, and I don't know that God's love for me unconditionally, and if it's I believe in a works-based doctrine, then if I miss it, then the devil comes against me and is coming to me because of persecution, coming because of what I'm doing right and not necessarily because of what I'm doing wrong. You guys heard what I said? We're getting persecuted sometimes not because of what we're doing wrong, but maybe because of what we're doing right. Persecution is coming into our lives. Now we need to know our authority. But if our authority, the devil can come and bring guilt, shame, and condemnation, our conscience is constantly condemning us because we don't know who we are in Christ. You guys see the circle right here? I'm just giving you guys a simple way of walking victoriously, living a victorious Christian life. This is how you do it right here. It's this simple. It's not complicated at all. Right? But if I have the authority inside of me, I have all power and authority to rule and reign on this earth. Every spirit is subject to me. I don't have to fast and pray to get rid of any devils, okay? I know that. I'll teach on that next week. Okay? I don't need to fast and pray to get rid of any devils. Just take my word for it today. I'll back it up with scripture next week, okay? We have all power and authority to rule and reign on this earth. And if a spirit is coming against us, you have that authority. In Jesus' name, you're a child of the King. But what's going to undermine that and cause you to not be able to use your authority is if I'm allowing guilt, shame, and condemnation to hinder that. Make sense? Four pillars right there. You need to know your identity in Christ. You need to know that God loves you unconditionally. You need to operate in wisdom. You're not messing up God's plans and all the things that God is trying to accomplish in our lives. Operating with God, giving wisdom. Seek wisdom. When you read the true Proverbs, Proverbs is talked about like the third person there. Seek it. Wisdom is calling out to us. Come, seek me with everything within you. Seek wisdom. Let wisdom be your guide. The wisdom is actually, if you study it out, wisdom is the Holy Spirit. Seek wisdom in every area. Let wisdom guide and direct you. When the Holy Spirit is prompting you, it make total sense to go in this direction, and everything that you know is telling you to do this, do this, do this. But wisdom is telling you don't do that right now. That's death down that road. You need to listen to that direction that the Holy Spirit is prompting you. Wisdom will guide and direct you. It'll be the umpire in your life. It calls the shots. Amen.
Amen.
And we need to know authority. We have all power and authority. Just speak to that mountain and be cast into the sea. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So with that, I just want to encourage you guys in this. Anybody that is trying to just be a blessing to our brother Lance here, and I believe that this is a landmark day in your life. This is going to be a landmark day in your life. Don't leave right after service. I want to talk to you for a little while, okay? Help you get down the right path. Put something together for you so that you can truly walk this out and walk from this place right now. That more thing in your life can change right now.
Amen.
Most things in our lives, guys, it doesn't have to be a long process.
That's right.
It's a simple, simple change. A little 5-degree change oftentimes. That is what's going to make the difference in our life between being a train wreck or walking a victorious life in Jesus Christ. I can tell you this, that if you choose, we got some younger folks here, and I tell you what, If you choose to do things God's way in your lives, I can tell people here, adults here, that have been around for a while, and I guarantee you that if we had all day and I gave them the mic, they would talk all day about this, that if I had chosen, if I had known then when they were at your age what they know now, they would have done things God's way. I can guarantee you that I could have every adult here come here and tell you, if I had done it God's way, I could have been at a whole different place and get there a whole lot sooner. The things that we seek in life that you think is going to produce the things that you're seeking for, Jesus is the source for everything that we need. Jesus is the source for everything that we need. When we enter into the kingdom of God, what is the kingdom of God? What is the kingdom of God? You guys remember? The kingdom of God is God's system or God's way of doing things. Okay? The kingdom of God is God's system or God's way of doing things. And when the sooner we can enter into the kingdom of God and start doing things God's way, then we're not chasing our tails going in circles, not getting nowhere. You get into advancement mode rather than cleanup mode. It's just a moment, guys. It doesn't take a lifetime to get there. It's just a moment, just a change, just like that. I can choose today, right now, that I'm going to start doing things God's way, right now. Make a choice. Start, God, I'm going to seek you with everything that I have. And right there, boom. That simple. See, the devil likes to complicate it and make it difficult so that we have to spend years and years and years, and you have to do this and you have to do that, and then we get into a works-based doctrine, and then you end up like my friend that I was just ministering to last night. My brother. We see this all the time. Brother has an evangelistic gift on his life. Was involved in ministry heavily, just on fire for Jesus, always witnessing to people. All this craziness started happening, ended up getting into depression, and right now he's an alcoholic. And this is a common thread, guys. You know what happened in his life? He went from this place. You see, if you're trying to get deliverance in your own ability, you can sustain your deliverance only as far as your willpower can take you. Your willpower can only take you as long as you don't hit that perfect storm. If you're not truly delivered because of what Jesus did and what Jesus is accomplishing inside of our lives, then all it's going to take, like what happened to my friend here, was that perfect storm to come. And all of a sudden, after many, many, many years, we see this 10, 15, 20 years down the road, they end up right back where they were, and sometimes even worse than they were, because they were doing it in their own ability, based on their own strength, based on feelings and emotion, because I'm strong today. I got the support systems in place. I can do this in my own ability right now. Thank you, Jesus. And then something happens. True deliverance is not true deliverance, true repentance. You guys understand what repentance is? See, we think of repentance as someone groveling up here at the altar telling Jesus, sorry for what I did again. True repentance is simply this. Repentance is having a change of mind. That is the true definition of repentance. Repentance means that I do not think of what I just did, the sin that I did, the same way that I did, and I'm trying, I feel bad for what I did. That is not true repentance. True repentance is that I see what I did, and I see how bad it is, and I see the consequences of, and I see how it's affecting me and affecting everybody else, and I see it for what it is, and I turn from it. I have a change of mind so that I am no longer seeing sin the same way. Now that sin disgusts me rather than it's enticing me. That is true repentance. That is when you know that repentance truly takes place. That's why when someone comes back and the word says, shall sin abound so that grace may much more abound. Far be it. How can someone who's been delivered from that slavery of sin subject yourself back under that sin again? See, when freedom comes, brother, freedom is right there for you. Freedom is right there for you. It's not a long process. You just need help walking through it. It's the gospel, the true gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ that sets us free so that we can be truly free and free indeed. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, Father, I thank you, Lord. I thank you for your faithfulness and your goodness. I thank you for the work that you're doing through this ministry right now, Lord. I thank you, Lord God, that people just hearing the truth of the gospel are being set free right now. And even as people watch the videos later, Lord God, that your freedom will come from them, Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord God, that it's not a long process, that we don't have to wait months and years to be free, but Lord Jesus, that we can get to that place today. We can make a choice today, and we can be truly free, Lord God. Truly set free from the things that plague our lives, Lord. The things that are hindering us, the things that are the addictions and different things, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, that we can receive deliverance right now and walk a victorious life. I thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Lord, we give you all praise, glory, and honor, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to open up the altar. I'm not going to take it for granted that everybody accepted Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. If anybody hasn't accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I encourage you to raise your hand. That's the most important thing, most important decision. And I tell you what, you know, sometimes people, oh, pastor, they want to do this secret service, kind of deliverance service here. People are going to raise their hand and quiet. But let me tell you something, man. If you can't make a decision for Jesus when everybody's going to be cheering you on, there's going to be a whole heck of a lot harder out there in the world where people are opposing you. Amen? Do anybody here want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Everybody saved? Everybody going to heaven?
Yep.
Okay, that's the main thing. Okay. Well, I just want to open up the altar. If anybody needs prayer,